Elon Musk's highly anticipated Tesla diner officially welcomed in its first guests at exactly 4:20 p.m. on LA's Santa Monica Boulevard, further demonstrating what Tesla bot humanoids can do in the real world. The latest Optimus Gen 3 stands 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighs approximately 125 pounds, and can carry up to about 45 pounds. Powered by Tesla's advanced full self-driving AI, Optimus features 22 degrees of freedom in its hands for enhanced dexterity, enabling it to hand out popcorn at the Tesla diner for now, with other tasks possibly being added over time. The Optimus uses multicam neural networks and sensors for real-time object recognition and spatial awareness, but its level of automation versus teleoperation is still unknown. Nevertheless, these diners may serve as a sort of extra training environment for Tesla Optimus humanoids to help them develop and refine home robot skills to be included in commercial releases later on. There are also reports from Chinese suppliers of Tesla parts that the robot is undergoing a redesign, with these manufacturers expecting orders for robot parts to resume in around 2 months. And next to the humanoids, the Tesla diner features multiple 45-foot movie screens outdoors, allowing patrons to watch films while charging their electric vehicles. As for power, the main supercharger area accommodates around 35 vehicles at once, with everything from burgers, to sandwiches, to even fried chicken and more being offered on the food menu. Meanwhile, Engineered Arts just announced a significant new feature for its robot called Roles, providing an intuitive way to define the robot's behavior, preferred interaction style, and knowledge base according to different situations. To get started, users simply access their robot's web-based user interface and log in to their Tritium account, where the Roles interface is now available. There are currently 5 core tabs within Roles: identity for basic details, languages to set preferred speech and voices, personality to adjust interaction style or choose from presets, knowledge for adding specialist company or product information, and abilities where users can toggle specific capabilities as needed. On top of this, Roles allows for quick adjustments, where users can change the robot's name, home location, or limit spoken languages to just one or multiple options. Furthermore, it is possible to assign a personalized set of skills, such as enhancing vision capability or the ability to recognize voices for an improved customer experience, all without any coding required. By simplifying customization and expanding flexibility, the company hopes to drive wider adoption of humanoid robots in customer service, retail, and specialized tasks, where personal interaction and expertise are key.
To bring warmth and energy to this industrial space, consider a bold color like sapphire salute or a soothing shade like tranquil dawn. These hues can enhance the room's ambience, adding character and vibrance. Would you like to explore any particular shades?
But robots are also now capable of growing themselves by simply recycling parts from others. This was just demonstrated at Columbia University, with researchers having unveiled this breakthrough process that lets robots physically grow by absorbing materials from their environment, or even reusing parts from fellow machines. Detailed in their study published in Science Advances, the new technique, which they call robot metabolism, takes inspiration from biology, enabling robots to self-assemble, repair, and adapt in response to new needs. Additionally, the team has demonstrated what's called the Truss Link, a modular, magnetic robot based on the simple, bar-shaped connectors, but with a twist. That's because each Truss Link can freely connect to others at various angles, forming complex shapes and three-dimensional robots that can morph and adapt. On top of this, these robots are able to physically integrate new parts. For example, a robot shaped like a tetrahedron was able to add another link and use it like a walking stick, speeding up its descent by more than 66.5%. Furthermore, roboticists believe that creating machines capable of such self-directed growth is the beginning of resilient, self-sustaining robot ecologies, setting a clear path for evolving autonomous machines in the future. And when it comes to upcoming AI tech, Gemini 3.0 is shaping up to be the next major milestone for Google DeepMind's large language models. In fact, references to internal versions, such as Beta 3 Pro and Beta 3 Flash, have now surfaced in the open-source Gemini command line tool, indicating final preparations for a feature-rich upgrade. Notably, Gemini 3.0 introduces an advanced deep-think reasoning architecture. This system aims to take on complex, multi-step reasoning tasks more accurately, Plus, it comes with built-in verifier reasoning by default, streamlining output quality and reducing user intervention. On top of this, Gemini 3.0 will extend its multimodal input capabilities. Whereas Gemini 2.5 already processed text, images, audio, and short videos, this new release is expected to support real-time video at up to 60 frames per second, plus 3D object understanding and geospatial analysis. Furthermore, its context window will reportedly expand into the multi-million token range, allowing the model to handle extremely long documents while maintaining coherent memory and retrieval. In terms of performance, Gemini 3.0 will leverage Google's next-generation TPU v5P accelerators to ensure nearly real-time responses. The current timeline, based on Google's annual release cadence, points to a likely December 2025 rollout. And finally, with the launch of Kiro, Amazon is introducing a new contender in the fast-evolving landscape of artificial intelligence software tools. The company has rolled out Kiro, a fully AI-powered integrated development environment in public preview. But what sets Kiro apart is its ambition to tackle the growing problem of underdocumented, AI-generated software, an increasingly common headache as companies accelerate their development pipelines with artificial intelligence. Unlike traditional coding assistants, Kiro deploys autonomous AI agents designed to not only help write code, but also automatically generate, update, and track technical documentation and project plans as work progresses. On top of this, it aims to create seamless transitions from rapidly built prototypes to production-level systems with robust requirements, proper testing protocols, and centralized up-to-date documentation. Furthermore, Kiro stands apart from peers, such as GitHub's Agent Mode and Google's Gemini Code Assist, by breaking down a developer's intent into structured, trackable components. Each prompt is deconstructed into requirements, design docs, and task lists, which are dynamically updated as code changes. Plus, automated checks are run whenever files are saved or modified, with the system handling critical tasks like updating documentation and scanning for inconsistencies. Though Kiro is developed by an Amazon Web Services team, its launch avoids prominent Amazon branding, with just subtle references such as an AWS logo in the footer. For now, Kiro is available without charge during its preview phase, with paid tiers planned. A free tier capped at 50 agent interactions per month, a pro offering at $19 monthly for up to 1,000 interactions, and a pro plus tier costing $39 per month for 3,000 interactions. Anyways, make sure to like and subscribe and tell us whether or not the CL3 is a good dancer. Thank you.